Hello all, my name is Ashutosh Rastogi. I am a teacher by profession. My mission is to impart quality education for all. For that purpose, I am creating these videos. If you appreciate my work, then please do like my video and subscribe my channel so that I could get the motivation to prepare more videos. Anyways, today in this particular lecture, we will try to discuss about the classification of handoff. So these are the outlines. We're going to start up with the introduction, where we're going to describe whatever we have studied in our last lecture. Then we're going to discuss different types of handoffs based on these three parameters, that is present in different technologies, different devices involved in your handoff process, as well as link transfer processes. So in our last lecture, we have discussed about the handoff process as well as your handoff region, how handoff will going to take place. Then we have also discussed about various methods of prioritizing handoff along with the practical handoff situations, such as your speed mismatch among your different users, as well as your cell dragging. So now in this particular lecture, we're going to discuss about the taxonomy of handoff processes. So here we're going to present this classification of handoff, which is based on these three parameters, that is based upon used in different technologies, that is different types of technologies used which type of handoff. So here the classification is, we're going to have this hard handoff as well as soft handoff, whereas this hard handoff would have been used in your GSM structures and soft handoff would have been used in your CDMA structure. Then second parameter is your based on different types of participating devices, that is which particular devices will going to participate in your handoff process. This classification consists of two parts, that is your mobile assisted handoff as well as your network control handoff. And third parameter is your based upon the link transfer. Here the classification is about your intra-system handoff as well as your inter-system handoff. So if handoff would have been taken place inside a particular system or inside the coverage region of MSC, that would have been considered as your intra-system handoff. And if this handoff would have been going to take place among different MSCs or coverage of different MSCs, then that particular handoff would have been considered as your inter-system handoff. So now we're going to discuss all of them one by one. So first one is your hard handoff, that is depending upon which particular technology use which type of handoff process. So here the keyword is your break before make. So this particular terminology basically signifying that here first the connecting base station connection would have been break, and then we will going to make new base station connections. So this type of handoff would have been present in your FDMA as well as TDMA based your 1G as well as 2G systems. So here mobile does not have this functionality that it could connect multiple base stations simultaneously. So that is why mobile has a radio link with only one base station at a particular time, and if while moving, its signal strength will going to get deteriorated with the connected base station, and it is moving towards your another base station. So obviously the received signal strength from second base station will going to get increased. So at a particular time where the received signal strength falls below the predetermined threshold value, link would have been transferred via disconnecting from the first base station first and connecting with the second base station instantaneously. This sort of operation will going to take place. So here old base station connection is terminated before new base station connection is made. This is what we had already discussed. So this is the specification of your FDMA, TDMA based 1G as well as 2G systems. So this type of handoff is mainly used in your GSM based systems. And nowadays also it is also going to present in your UMTS system or your 4G cellular systems. Second one is your soft handoff. So this sort of handoff would have been present in your CDMA systems. So here the keyword is your make before break. That is first we have to make connection with the second base station, and after sufficient amount of time, when your mobile station is getting sufficient amount of power from your second base station, then it must have to break its link from the first serving base station. So radio shares the same channel in all cells. Since in your CDMA, we will going to use same frequency band for the signal transmission, and here in this CDMA based systems, all signal would have been transmitted just like your noise like signal in your spread spectrum systems. So here no physical change of assigned channels would have been occur, just because all frequencies would have been used by all the users simultaneously. Just different base station handles the ongoing call. So as the user is moving from one base station to another base station, since frequencies are same, so there is no frequency allocation will going to take place. Just a serving base station will get changed. So in this soft handoff, MSC continuously monitors the data about the received signal levels of the mobile at various base stations, and
it will going to make decisions, that is from which particular base station it is getting better received signal strength, and depending upon that criteria, mobile station will going to switch to a better base station at any given point. So this is how your soft handoff will going to take place. So now second criteria is your network controlled handoff. That is, handoff would have been supported by your network devices. So this particular figure is basically showing your typical mobile communication scenario where user is moving from this particular cell to this particular cell, and these are basically showing its received signal strength. So this particular first curve is basically showing the mobile user's received signal strength with respect to base station first, and this particular curve is basically showing its received signal strength with respect to second base station. So as this particular moment, when the received signal strength from both the cell will become equal, then at this particular point network starts its handoff process, or it will start monitoring this, that this particular mobile user might get required some handoff. So it is basically present in your first generation cellular system. Each base station constantly monitors the signal strength from mobiles in its cell. Since in your first generation cellular systems, our mobile phone are not that much capable, or they will be having very low processing capability, so that is why here network has to take this responsibility that at when we need to perform this handoff process so that user calls could not get dropped. So based on the measure, the MSC decides if handoff is necessary or not. So obviously this receive signal strength input will going to gives the information to the MSC that whether the received signal strength is capable enough to handle the call properly or not. So depending upon those inputs, MSC will going to decide whether handoff is necessary or not. Here in this particular situation, mobile plays a passive role in this process, since all the computation as well as this handoff process would have been initiated as well as maintained by your network devices only. So obviously in this particular scenario, we will going to put heavy burden on the MSC, since MSC itself has to monitor the received signal strength parameter of individual users. Next is your mobile assisted handoff. Since in your network control handoff, your mobile is playing your passive role, whereas in this mobile assisted handoff, mobile will going to play an active role. That is, it itself will going to suggest the MSC that whether it is basically requiring some sort of handoff or not. So this mobile assisted handoff is basically present in your second generation TDMA systems. Here mobile measures the received power from the surrounding base stations, and after processing it will going to report this particular received signal strength to the serving base station. So handoff initiated when power received from a neighboring cell exceeds current value by a certain level or for a certain period of time. So here all this computation would have been computed by your mobile phone only, and it itself will going to request the MSC that now at this particular moment, since its received signal strength is falling below the certain level, so it might need some sort of handoff. So it is faster, since measurement is made by mobiles, MSC doesn't need to monitor the signal strength. So here the computation load over the MSC would have been countered by the processing capabilities of your mobile phone. Since all the computation would have been done by your mobile phone itself, and it is playing your active role in this handoff process, so this will definitely going to reduce out the computation burden on your MSC. So next is your intra-system handoff. So depending upon link transfer, that is movement of user is from where to where, that is whether it is moving from one cell to another cell, or it is moving from one BSC to another BSC, or within the same BSC. So there are several states where user might get mobile. Since we haven't studied this hierarchical structure of our GSM based systems, where in your network hierarchy, on the topmost hierarchy we'll be having this MSC, then BSC, then BTS. So when we're going to study this GSM architecture, then at that situation we will going to discuss it into the greater detail. As of now, just consider that we will be having a particular bigger system whose logical module is your MSC, or basically a MSC is responsible for serving several others users. So if we are performing this particular handoff where user is moving from one base station to another base station, same serving MSC is there and it is responsible for this link transfer. So generally this happens within the same serving MSC. This is what I have already described. So depending upon the user movement, the link transfer may happen within the same BTS, within the different BTS, within the same BSc, within different BSc. Obviously, all these structures would have been discussed into greater detail when we're going to discuss about your GSM architecture. So as of now, so if you are talking about within different base stations, that is from one cell site to another cell site, link would have been transferred. Similar is the case for your BSc, and similar is the case for your different sorts of BSc. So here the key idea is all other parameters which are essential for performing successful handoff situation will going to remain same. Only link transfer will going to take place. So intra-system handoff is basically considered, and here only simple link transfer will going to take place. So this is also one type of handoff. Then second one is your inter-system handoff. So here the consideration is, if a user is particularly moving from the coverage of one MSC to another MSC. So here, just as the case we have discussed in your intra-system handoff, where we have already mentioned that all the particular parameters which are essential for the handoff will going to remain same. Just like if you talk about your policy, charging schemes, etc., there are other parameters too. So in inter-system handoff, we have to consider another important parameters also, just in order to perform this successful handoff situation. And what are they? Let us discuss. So here we are considering that mobile is situated at the border of the system, that is from home service provider service area. And if particular user is moving from home service provider service area to another service area, then we have to consider other parameters also while performing this handoff properly. That is, if particular mobile user is basically moving from one country to another country, then we must have to look forward that in another country where user is particular moving, what type of implementation situation is there. So MSC of serving cell talks to the MSC of the neighboring systems, or vice versa. So obviously this communication would have been take place amongst your networking devices. Here MSC is there to converse it and check out that whether the same standards would have been followed in both the MSCs or not. And depending upon mutual consent, your services will get sustained in your serving MSC also. So several issues must have to be resolved before handoff can take place, and these are various typical points that we are talking about, that different MSCs must have to consent on a particular point, then only your second MSC will going to start servicing to the mobile user, otherwise call will going to drop. So what are these issues? So first of all, call type, that is what type of call it is, whether it is your voice call or it is your data call. Roaming is allowed or not? That is, if you are talking about this roaming services, since mobile user is moving from one MSC to another MSC, so in this particular situation, roaming call is allowed or not? If it is allowed, then call will be through, otherwise call will get disconnected. Compatibility issues, here standards will going to comes into picture, and the typical scenario that we have discussed is, suppose a particular user is moving from one country to another country, so there might be some certain compatible issues, that is one country is following one standard, another country is following different standards. So if there is a standard mismatch, then user is not in a state to continue its call in the second MSC's coverage. User authenticity as well as your call charging issues. Since we are talking about inter-system handoff, so here call charging issues and user authenticity is also a major concern. So after authenticating user properly, and both these MSCs will going to have common consent over the call charging issues, that is how call will get charged, that is per minute basis, per second basis, or a particular fixed amount will be there. So these issues would have been resolved first before making up this handoff calls successfully. So these are the various classification, as or you could say taxonomy, of your handoff processes. Hopefully you guys have got the proper insight about it. Just in case of any doubt, you can ask me in the comment section. I'll try to solve them out as soon as possible. So these are the references. Thank you very much for your patient hearing.